Hello and welcome back to the Melge Gaming YouTube channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Elgato Stream Deck and I'm going to be trying to give you a few ideas and ways that you can utilize it that you might not have thought of yet. Now the Elgato Stream Deck is a staple piece of equipment that you will find on most streamers' desks. It's normally one of the first things past a mic and a camera that a streamer will buy. With the Stream Deck being so commonplace amongst streamers, I figured it would be a good thing to do a video on. And what we're going to aim to do is show you some of the more out of the box or out there ways that you can utilize the Stream Deck to your advantage. Hopefully you should know by now that I'm aiming to put out 2 videos a month on YouTube aimed at giving growth and tech advice to smaller and newer streamers. So if that sounds like something that would be of interest to you, then please make sure that you subscribe and turn on notifications to get notified when the new videos go live. But for now, let's get into it. Okay, so let's start with the basics. You're probably already using your Stream Deck to do this, but if you're not, then you absolutely should be. And that is OBS control. So you can use your Stream Deck to control different parts of OBS. One of the main reasons that streamers tend to pick up a Stream Deck is because it allows them to control parts of OBS Studio without having to alt-tab out of their game. So they can change scenes at the press of a button. So they can go from their gameplay scene to their just chatting scene, and all they have to do is just press one button on the Stream Deck. And you can use the Stream Deck to do a lot inside of OBS. You're not limited to just swapping scenes. You can do things like mute and unmute your mic at the press of a button, or even make different sources visible so you could have buttons programmed to play GIFs or to play sound files as well. These commands are included natively with the Stream Deck. They will work straight out of the box. All you need to do is open up the Stream Deck application that is on the desktop and go to the OBS Studio section on the right, and you'll see a drop down that will give you lots of different options that you can drag and assign to any button on the Stream Deck. These commands are really, really useful. They will save you loads of time and faffing around. If you've not got them set up, then definitely get them set up ASAP. Now, the second thing that I want to talk to you about is using your Stream Deck to send messages to your Twitch chat that will come directly from your Twitch account and not from a bot. So, for example, if you wanted to make your viewers aware that you've got various social medias out there, you've got a couple of options as to how you can approach this. You can alt-tab out of your game, open your stream up, go to your stream chat, and type in the links to your social media, you know, www.twitter.com/melgegaming, and do that for every social media. Obviously, really inefficient. Just going to break up the flow of your stream. This is not going to work very well for you. The second option, which is a step in the right direction, is to set up a bot command. So you go to a chat bot. I use Moobot, but there's Nightbot and various other versions as well. It really doesn't matter which one you're using. But you go and you set up a command, say !socials, so that all you have to do is type !socials into your chat, and a bot will respond providing links to all of your social media channels. But we can do better than that. Using the Stream Deck, you can craft a personalized message that gets sent at the push of a button. And when it gets sent, it's sent from your Twitch account and not from a bot. Obviously, you're not limited to doing this for just socials either. You can do it for any kind of message, whether it's a welcome message or a thank you message, or a this is how you sub, this is how you follow message. They're all there at the push of a button and they come from your account and not from a bot. And personally, I think that looks a bit better. Obviously, you can still have bots posting stuff into your chat on a timer, but when you need something dynamically ready at your fingertips, the Stream Deck will allow you to send a message straight into the chat from your Twitch account. Again, this is another one that is natively included with the Stream Deck. It will work out of the box. You just need to open the application on your desktop and go to the Twitch section and select Twitch Message. This next one is a big one and it's a real massive time saver for me. If you're anything like me, then you have a ton of programs that you open before you stream. To give you an example, just some of the ones that I use are RTX Voice, OBS, Lumia Stream, Streamlabels, Snaz, Discord, Chatty. You get the idea, the list goes on and on. There's a lot of apps to open. Sometimes I forget to open them, And I like to have them in the right place on the right monitor so I know exactly where to look and I'm not wasting time, you know, looking through my start bar trying to find the right program or app. Now this next plugin really helps with that. The plugin that I'm talking about is called Windows Resizer and Mover, and it does not come natively included with your Stream Deck. You will need to download and install it. To do that, you need to open up the Stream Deck application on your desktop. You'll need to click More Actions in the bottom right and search for Windows Mover and Resizer, and then click to install it. Once you've installed it, you'll see a new category on the right-hand side called Windows Mover. Now, what we want to do is we want to create a multi-action button, and we're going to drag multiple Windows Movers to that multi-action button. That's going to mean that we can press this button just once, and it will move all of our apps to the right places on the right monitors for us. So once you've dragged some Windows Movers over to the multi-action button, go ahead and click on one of those Windows Movers. You will need to select specific application and tell it which application you want it to position. You'll need to then move that app to where you want it to be on the screen, and you'll need to click the Get Current Coordinates button. That will then remember where you've placed that app, and then when you press this multi-action button, it will move it back to that exact same place. Now you repeat this for each of the Windows Movers in your multi-action button, each one of those being a different application. Now, when you click your multi-action button, all of your apps will snap to their relevant places, even across multiple monitors. It's a massive time-saving tool. You can just open up all your apps, hit the button, and everything goes where it should be, whether it's maximized, half a screen, whatever, it will snap it to the right place for you. Great tool, would highly recommend. Now, of course, this next one was always going to make an appearance in my list, and it is, of course, Lumia Stream. Lumia Stream is the program that I use to let my viewers control my room lights and my keyboard and mouse lights through chat commands. It's a great application and it allows you to hook up things like Philips Hue lights, like I've got in my room here, as well as things like Nanoleafs, LiFX lights, Razer peripherals, and more. It works with Twitch, YouTube, Facebook Gaming, and Glimesh as well, and there is a Stream Deck plugin for it too. Now, with this plugin, I can trigger things like alerts or reactions that are built within Lumia, but are triggered directly from my Stream Deck. I can turn my lights on or off, or start or stop Lumia just at the press of a button. So that's a big time saver for me. You can install the Lumia plugin for the Stream Deck in the same way that you did with the Windows Mover and Resizer. So open up the Stream Deck app, go to the bottom right, go to More Actions, and look for the Lumia Stream app and install it. This last tool is extremely powerful and it's an absolute must for streamers with a Stream Deck. It's a suite of tools known as Twitch tools. This also does not come as standard with your Stream Deck, so you will need to install it. So again, open up your Stream Deck app, go to the bottom right hand corner, click More Actions and search for Twitch tools. Go ahead, download and install it. Twitch Tools comes with some really, really cool features. One of the main ones that I like is that it allows you to shout people out from your Stream Deck. So you can set up a shout out button, and when you press it, your Stream Deck will change to show you the profile pictures of all of your viewers at the moment. You then select the profile picture that you want to shout out, and your Stream Deck will send a shout out into your Twitch chat for you, which I thought was amazing, really cool. Twitch Tools has a button called Live Streamers. If you drag this across and assign it to a button, when you push it, it will show you a list of all the streamers that you follow that are currently live. And to go one further, if you then select a channel by pushing the button with the relevant profile picture on it, it will initiate a raid to that channel, which I thought, again, was really cool and a great time saver. Twitch Tools will also let you host giveaways directly from your Stream Deck, which I think is great. It means you don't have to go to your chatbot to be setting up giveaways, and you can do it all at the push of a few buttons. The giveaway function allows you to set an entry command that your viewers need to type into chat in order to enter the giveaway. It will automatically send reminders to your chat. It will post a message when it's selected a winner. And of course, it will keep track of who has entered, and it will pick a winner for you as well. Really handy to not have to go off to a chatbot to be able to do a giveaway on the fly. If I'm being honest with you, Twitch Tools is so powerful that I could probably do a whole video on just Twitch Tools alone. Again, I'd really, really recommend that you get this one installed on your Stream Deck and start having a play around with it and see what kind of features will work for you. And that sums up my favorite Stream Deck plugins. These ones are really useful. I use all of them. All of them are on my Stream Deck and they will get used every stream. And I would highly recommend that you check all of these out. No doubt there are some great plugins out there that I haven't mentioned, so please share with us. Let us know in the comments what are you using your Stream Deck that works really well for you. As always, remember to like, subscribe, comment, and turn on notifications to get notified when future videos go live. And thanks for watching.